I'm Hannah Buck, and I love my 419.
Yes, you do, girl.
This city rocks. We love the 419.
Happy Sunday, everyone, and welcome into Love My 419 on NBC 24. I'm Andrew Z, Meredith Solo, Steve Remy. We are at Fatty's Diner. They open this morning at 8 a.m., so we come in here at 7:30 to do a little talk show before we start making the donuts at 8 o'clock. And I actually make the donuts here, Steve, so.
I don't know.
So come on into Fatty's Diner, 2633 West Bancroft. We got a busy show for you today, you guys. Coming up, we're going to talk to a group called The Right Direction. And what they do is they use action sports as a catalyst to touch kids. Teach kids life skills, which is really cool.
I thought you said One Direction.
No,
I was like, where's that applause?
The right direction, not One Direction. One Direction is Steve's favorite group.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
wow. It's everyone.
Skinny jeans and long hair. Okay.
And also, we're going to talk to Hannah Buck. She's a 12-year-old. She's going to be in a big production. She goes to Toledo School for the Arts at December 4th, the Mommy Indoor Theater. She's actually come in and sing for us. Ooh. And also, Steve, our liaison to the community, he actually was at Veritas Cork and Craft downtown, so he's going to take us through that as well.
You are fancy.
Yes, we will take a break. We'll come back with more Love My 419 and NBC 24 from Fatty's Diner. Hang on. Welcome back to Love My 419 from Fatty's Diner. Andrew Z, Meredith Solo, and Steve Remy. And we're being joined by a special guest, 12-year-old Hannah Buck, who's a local student that goes to TSA. Hi, how are you doing, Hannah?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. Now, Hannah, I know that your mom told us that you've been in a ton of things already. How many productions have you been in already locally?
About 20.
20?
Wow!
That's
you're
awesome.
A child star.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, do you have an agent yet?
No.
Oh. You need one. Uncle Steve wants to be your agent.
and here's the deal, Hannah. Don't ever let your parents be your agents because it always ends bad.
Yes.
All right? We need to have some documents signed. They can't take all your money before you're 18.
That's
and then
right.
You end up on the streets.
Yeah.
I've seen this play out a million times.
It's
so
not
let the, it's not pretty. Yeah. Now, this is kind of cool now. Hannah, you got to tell us. Remember the Sound of Music with Carrie Underwood? What Steve that they did last year, the live production.
Yes, so good.
Hannah actually auditioned for that, isn't that right, Hannah?
Yes,
that's so cool.
Are you kidding me?
No, and she got a call back. So tell us. So you went to New York to audition with your mom, right? And then what happened?
Well, I went to audition and they were looking for a 9 and 13-year-old, and I was 11, so it was like right in the middle.
Uh-huh.
So I got past the singing round, but then I didn't get past the looks because I was 11. I didn't quite look 13, but I didn't quite look 9.
But still, I mean, that had to have been a cool experience for you,
it
right?
It was.
Some highlights would have helped you out.
So what was your favorite part of New York?
Well, the sightseeing. I see a lot of buildings, and so that was cool.
Very cool. So she's been in 20-plus productions here locally. Oregon, Perrysburg, all the different local community theaters you've been in. Well,
wow.
here's the other great thing. Since she goes to TSA, they're doing a big fundraiser, and the show is called, I have it right here, Dance and Tensions. It's December 4th at the Mommy Indoor Theater, and you're going to be one of the featured performers, right?
Yes, I'll be singing as well as dancing.
And good for you.
What song are you going to be singing?
We'll be singing Ben by Michael Jackson.
No.
Oh, look at Steve.
One of my favorites.
Look at Steve. Can you do it for us live here now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yes.
All right, here it is. All right, here we go. 12-year-old Hannah Buck. She's going to be performing this at the Mommy Indoor Theater December 4th. Here she is doing it live for us.
Ben, no two of us need love no more.
Oh, Steve. Steve, you look verklempt. Are you verklempt?
I'm Misty.
Misty.
Oh, Hannah, it was so good.
That was
good.
Amazing.
It was amazing.
12-year-old wow. Hannah Buck. You can see her perform that song at the Mommy Indoor Theater December 4th. The event is called Dance Intentions, and it's the Toledo School for the Arts. So make sure you go check it out. Get your tickets for the Mommy Indoor Theater. Thank you, Hannah.
Thank you.
All right, we got to take a break. Coming up next, The Right Direction. Wait, no,
One Direction.
For ratings, we're going to call them One Direction. Redo it. All right, coming up next, One Direction.
One Direction.
Stay tuned, NBC 24. This is Love My 419. Hang on.
Good job, man.
Are your wages being garnished? Did you know we can stop garnishments and also get some of the money garnished back for you? For more information on this subject, please call us.
This segment of Love My 419 is brought to you in part by Boss Bonds Bail Bonds. When in trouble, get out. Call Chris Ross today. 24/7, Better Business Bureau certified.
Welcome back to Love My 419. I'm Andrew Z, Meredith Solo, and Steve Remy. We're joined by a bunch of special guests. We're at Fatty's Diner, 2633 West Bancroft. We're here, and Fatty's opens at 8 a.m. for the best breakfast in town. This is the world's best diner. Trust me, come check it out. We're here all day long. All right, now our special guests here, One Direction, everyone! Right? You guys are One Direction?
Yeah. Is it Charlie or is there a Harry?
Is it Harry? Yeah.
Harry.
I'm no, Harry. You guys aren't One Direction. See, Meredith booked you, and I would have never let you guys on. She said it was
One Direction.
You
don't
know your beautiful.
You got some pull.
Anyway, this is actually The Right Direction, and we have Don, and we have Kurt in the middle, and then we have Matt there at the end. And what they do is they use action sports to teach kids life skills. Now, I know you guys, kind of explain a little more about that, Don, what you guys do.
One of the things that we do is we help develop talent. So we take kids that are beginner athletes, and we help them become better in their sport. So we'll take kids that maybe have never tried skateboarding, bicycling, motocross, but maybe are a good athlete, and help develop them into a professional athlete.
Wow.
That's very cool. So are you a professional athlete then? Or?
You know, I raced professionally from the time I had graduated high school till college. I was in the Olympics in 96, and I got involved in mountain biking. And that's actually what transitioned me into do what I did. I always took a couple of kids under my wing and helped develop them into better athletes. And what we found in doing it is not only were we helping develop talent, but we were helping kids who were starting to stray and go the wrong path. So we had kids who couldn't afford a $4,000 mountain bike, but I raised sponsorship dollars and got them equipment to compete.
That's awesome. Now, give us one quick story from the Olympics. Your favorite story, your favorite memory from the Olympics.
Oh, don't do that to
him. What? It was crazy. So in 96, when I went to the Olympics, so we had to stay in the it was in Georgia Tech in Atlanta. So we stayed. The dorms were the Olympic quarters and stuff. Where when we got picked, they took the top 10 athletes from each country. And we were staying with a bunch of kids from France that absolutely know zero English whatsoever. So we pretty much just had a great time with them. And we were just saying all sorts of random stuff that meant nothing to them the entire time. We were teaching them words and doing all this crazy stuff that had no bearing on what was actually going on the whole time. We would go to restaurants and order food, and they would just start blurting out random stuff. It was hilarious.
How'd they smell? I hear French people don't smell
right. It was bad.
It was bad.
Oh,
oh,
yeah. it's not a good thing. There's no regular hygiene involved. Trust me.
Now, Kurt, tell us, so why did you get involved, and what is the coolest thing that you've seen come out of this program, The Right Direction?
I got involved with it a year and a half. Was it a year and a half
about
ago?
About a year and a half ago, yeah.
Year and a half ago. Pretty much, I wanted to always be a part of something like this. Growing up, I raced motocross, was decently successful at it, and just never had enough background to help me and sponsors. So seeing something like this, I was all about it. Want to give kids that have the potential to be something to support them. So I was all about it. Matt introduced me to the program, and I've been here ever since, helping kids with training, working out, eating programs like nutrition programs and stuff, dieting, and just helping on and off the track with
Matt, yeah. What is a story that's touched you the most? Maybe a kid that's come up to you.
There's been quite a few, to be honest with you. One of the biggest ones for us by far, there's two kids from Trinidad that came to school up here. They knew nobody. When they came in here, they went to BG, they were kind of the outcasts. One of them really liked BMX, and the other one was just starting to like skateboarding. And kind of out of nowhere, they kind of started coming to the park, and then that's when Don was really active in that. And the kids just came up, and they're like, hey, you know, we don't got a lot of friends around here. Can we get to know you guys? And then we started doing The Right Direction right around the same time they got here. And then out of nowhere, they went from being like these little outcast kids to just being completely immersed in a family of The Right Direction. You know, action sports does not have a family sense. You know, or organized sports, football, baseball, basketball, you got a team.
You're individual.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you're individuals. When you have a team, you have a sense of pride, like, oh, these are my boys. You know, you got everybody with you. You don't. In action sports, you're just a kid out by yourself. So that's one of the main reasons why I got excited for this program is, you know, we have a sense of community. And when these kids came in, they went from, you know, we're not really good at these sports and we don't have a lot of friends. Now they're super popular in school. They're great. They're great role models for what
that's
we do.
Great.
And they're both incredible athletes. They've gone from, you know, I don't even know how to ride a skateboard, you know, winning contests. They're phenomenal athletes.
Now, Don, how can people get more information? How can they help to get more information on The Right Direction?
You can go to our website. It's www.therightdirection.org. You can also get us on Facebook. It's the Right Direction Youth Development Program. We are a 501c3 nonprofit, so everything we do, everything we get that comes in, goes 100% back to the program. So you can come on board and buy some merchandise from us that helps the kids out. You can come to our events and support us by showing up. Go to our Facebook page, like it.
Are those the hats? I like the hats.
Do you want that? I designed this logo on a napkin. Like, when we were trying to figure out, we were like, what could we do? What kind of logo could we make that kind of embodies what we want to do, The Right Direction? And it's cool because we use the negative space arrow with the other ones around it to kind of show either directions. It's neat. The program itself, when you look at what we do, it's cool because we have a nonprofit group. We mentor kids. We help work with kids. But we have professional athletes. And one of the cool standout things about our program is we have a demo team. We actually go around to schools, and we get some of the kids that want to be a part of our program, and we get them to go back to the schools and say, hey, Miss Jones or my principal, I want to do a fundraiser here. Let's get behind something. And what we tell the kids is, you know, come up with a cause on your own. A few years back, we did local schools. We did children's cancer patients in Toledo, Ohio. And we said, hey, get behind it. We'll come in with our professional athletes, do a demo that's a half hour. The school does nothing. You allow the kids to skip a class, come in, collect dollars, and all the money goes back to your cause. Then we go back and we chart where their money went so they can see what difference they made from just that one individual in a group of class. So it's huge.
Cool.
So everything we do involves a payback. When we have contests, they're free. We have canned food drives to give back to the community. We always have some form of giving back with it.
Very cool, you guys. What a great program. TheRightDirection.org. Okay, before we get out of here, we're going to use this for the promo, okay? So I'm going to say you're One Direction, and then you just got to say,
like,
that's what makes it beautiful. Okay, here we go. On the next show, One Direction. One Direction.
That's what makes it beautiful.
That's what makes it beautiful.
That's Liam on the next show. Good, that'll help us for ratings, guys. Good job.
There it is.
Don, Kurt, Matt, The Right Direction. Check them out at therightdirection.org. We're going to take a break. We'll come right back with more Love My 419 next from Fatty's Diner on NBC24.
Love My 419, a brand new weekly TV show highlighting the people, places, and stories that make us love the 419. Love My 419 with your host, Andrew Z, and the crew from Andrew Z in the Morning. Love My 419 from the people that brought you Game Savvy and Fit Zone by Erica. There's nothing else like it in Toledo TV. Love My 419. Welcome back to Love My 419, Sunday mornings at NBC 24. Andrew Z, Meredith Solo, and Steve Remy. Now, Steve, you were at Veritas downtown, Cork and Craft, right?
It's like wine heaven.
So it's like a bar or a restaurant?
It's more. I like to think of it as more than just a bar slash restaurant. It's a great place to actually learn about wine. So like, think of like wine college.
Like wine snob.
Wine snob, or like we call it in the industry, you can become a professional cork dork.
Oh, wait, you're in the industry?
Yeah. I am now.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
You should be my tab.
I don't know. Check out Steve and his in his little jaunt, his tete-a-tete at Veritas Cork and Craft.
Favorite place. I'm here with my friend Amy. What's going on? We haven't seen you for a while.
I know. I'm happy to be back.
Well, I'm bringing you to one of my favorite places, Veritas Cork and Craft. And I'm here with my friend, Matt Schneider, who's going to tell us a little bit about what the heck to pair with Thanksgiving meal.
What the heck? Yes. We've got the heck answers going on right here at Veritas.
Oh, he does. See. So, turkey, chicken,
turducken,
roast beef. What do you pair with what?
Pork tenderloin. Those are great questions, Steve. Some of our favorite suggestions for all the above, when anyone walks in our door, they have to have a bottle of bubbles right from the get-go. We're suggesting Gérard Bertrand Cremant Lemieux, beautiful sparkly wine from France.
Okay.
For the traditional, you know, turkey or turducken meals.
Exactly.
How do you not love a great little Willamette Pinot Noir? There we have the St. Innocent Temperance Hill Vineyard Pinot Noir. That is from the state of Oregon.
Really?
Third
like
left
from the
right.
States. I love it.
Yeah, this is the next tour from the states. The one in the middle here, Robert Klingenfuss, it's an Alsatian Pinot Gris. It is so creamy of a finish. It just keeps on lingering in its sexy little way. It's
really?
So food friendly. And last but not least, you need a cocktail wine just as the guests are getting there, because you know someone's going to show up early. Give them a glass of wine and have them chop up some vegetables.
I love it. So now you're talking my language.
Yeah.
Cocktail wine, you know.
Cocktail wine.
We want to get the drink on, so. So I noticed you poured us something in the glass. What are we trying?
This is the Bayonet. It's a nice, also, it's a bottle of wine from France. It's a blend of Grenache, Syrah, Carignan.
Okay.
Should we taste to make sure it's safe?
Yeah, huh? I would wait for
yeah,
me
too. Yeah,
oh,
hey.
Okay.
Me holiday too. Cheers. Clinkies.
Holiday cheers. Clink, clink.
Clinks.
Okay. Should I throw it around? You know, that's what they always say.
Well, I'd like to throw it back, but spin it around a little bit. We're going to do a little swirl. I think the swirl helps open up the bottle of wine. When you swirl it, you're letting the wine breathe.
Oh.
You're letting the bouquet come out. God. Give it a little snifferoo. It smells so beautiful.
Oh,
it releases the aromas in a really beautiful way.
See, so, I'm always curious when I drink wine. Like, what are the notes? They always talk about the notes in wine.
Yeah.
So what are we getting in this?
It's like going out to your garden and smelling the flowers. What are you picking up? It's a similar thing. Everyone wants to complicate things, you know? None of my beer drinking friends get all, you know, they don't stick their pinky up when they're having a beer, nor should you get all persnickety when you're having a wine. I mean, you're allowed to do it. It's your pinky. You can do whatever you want.
Matt, you know me.
You can do whatever you want.
Up at any time. I'm just saying. My pinky might go up.
You can do whatever you like with your pinky.
It just
I'm sorry.
Happen.
Duly noted. Gosh, I'm sorry. Strike that.
Right, so everybody wants to know where Veritas is at.
Oh, right here.
Yeah.
At the corner of Jefferson Superior, right across the street from Chef Erica's Registry Bistro. Our other partners across the street, our neighbors, are the Walleye or the Huntington Center.
Right.
It's a great place to come before, during, and after a concert, before, during, and after a hockey game. And then our other pals down the street, the Mud Hens. Go Hens.
Right around
the corner. We're sandwiched right between two county-funded arenas.
And I know you guys also, because when I came in early, I saw people actually taking wine out. That's the best part. You can come here and actually purchase wine.
All the above. You can enjoy it for here. You can take it to go. You can start it here and say, gosh, I just got paged or I got to be somewhere. We can put the cork back in it and seal it. We observe the Merlot to go law.
That's awesome.
So that's pretty cool, too.
Now, for those watching your budgets, what is your price range?
our price range? Ooh, you know what, Amy, that's a great question. We have something for everyone.
Okay.
Yeah, we have wine starting off as low as, you know, $8, $9, $10 a bottle, going up to you name it. Yeah, however many digits you want to put behind that in the checkbook, we can get it.
That won't be a problem.
Now I have the question of the day, and I'm sure many of the viewers are like, what does that word mean? What does Veritas mean? I know. I actually know. Any guesses?
Vino Veritas. In wine, there's truth. The truth.
There's truth. So they're always going to tell you the truth.
That's why I like wine.
It speaks the truth.
And if you drink too much, you're going to find out the truth.
You'll just be really honest. Maybe too honest.
Speak the truth. Yes. I love that.
Well, I'm telling you, Matt, thank you so much for sharing all your knowledge about wine and the choices that we should be making for Thanksgiving. And, you know, anytime we get together and have a glass of wine, it's good.
That's a good day of the week. Amy, cheers.
Okay, well, hopefully we'll see all you guys here at Veritas Cork and Craft.
Cheers.
Well, Steve, you look like you really put yourself into that one.
I drank. I took one for the team, and so did my friend Amy. You haven't seen her for a while.
I saw Amy.
Oh, girl was thirsty. I'm just saying. The girl was parched.
Check out Veritas Cork and Craft downtown. And that will wrap things up for this week's show. We're at Fatty's Diner, 2633 West Bancroft, the world's greatest diner. I'm telling you guys, it opens at 8 o'clock, so I got to go start getting stuff going.
I'm hungry.
I'm
working here. We'll be here all day. For Meredith Solo and Steve Remy, next week our special Thanksgiving Day episode. Meredith's been working hard on planning that thing. I can't wait to see give us some teases, what surprises we have for next week.
Yeah.
All right, there you go. Next week on NBC 24, right here at 7:30. Bye, guys. Thanks for tuning in to Love My 419.